Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Bitcoin is trading between 118 and 119,000 US dollars, and many of you are asking me, Dirk, is this still a good time now to buy Bitcoin, or should I wait, or are we already at the top, or where in this bull market is the top going to be? And I decided to actually show you three go-to models that you can use to answer this question for yourself. These are models I also use, and they have in the past helped me tremendously to decide when is a good time to buy Bitcoin, when is a good time to sell Bitcoin. All of these three models I have coded into TradingView indicators. So below the video in the pinned comment, you will find links to them. They are open source indicators, so you can, you know, adjust them in any way you like. And by the end of the day, I think they will greatly help you to understand at least, is Bitcoin currently overvalued or is Bitcoin undervalued? First indicator I want to talk about is the so-called Bitcoin logarithmic regression. What is a logarithmic regression? A logarithmic regression is supposed to explain things that grow very, very fast and then over time slow down. And this is, of course, the case for Bitcoin. In the past 15 years since its creation, we have gone from virtually nothing to now 119,000 US dollars. And I created so-called bands in terms of logarithmic regression that are supposed to identify, is the price of Bitcoin currently overvalued or undervalued? In a nutshell, this indicator will display two colored bands, first one being the upper one here, the red bands. Whenever we are close to those, it's a strong indication that Bitcoin is currently overvalued, and a lower green band, so on lower green bands. And there, especially in the lower half of those green bands, so that area here, this is a strong indication always that Bitcoin is extremely undervalued at the moment. So the last time we bottomed out there was, for example, here in October, in August of 2024, where we traded around 50,000 US dollars. Great chance to buy back then, and you basically would have more than doubled your money there in the past year. Now, what this model also shows very well, in my opinion, is that after each halving, there comes a time when Bitcoin likes to break out of the green channel and then eventually tops out at the red channel. So that was the case. After all the previous halvings that we saw, even if we go all the way back to 2012. And if that will happen again, and I don't see any reason why it shouldn't happen again, that would mean that eventually we would see Bitcoin breaking out and going maybe all the way up here, let's say to the lower red band, which would be trading somewhere around 200 to 250,000 US dollars. If that is going to happen again, this should happen until late October, late November of 2025. So there's not so much time left anymore for this to happen. But I mean, we've seen in the past very, very often how quickly Bitcoin can move. So Bitcoin logarithmic regression really gives you a good indication, in my opinion, is the current price of Bitcoin still somewhere where it's fair valued? So the fair value always would be the lower green line, the middle green line here in this case. This is always an area where I start to slowly accumulate Bitcoin again to sell it once it breaks into this uncolored channel, or maybe even all the way here at the top of the red band. Second model I want to show you is a very famous model, the stock to flow model, made famously by PlanB at 100 trillion US dollars on X as a handle. And this looks at Bitcoin through the eyes of a commodity, through the eyes of a scarce commodity. So here the main driver for the price of Bitcoin are the halvings, where the supply of Bitcoin is always cut in half. And you can calculate a ratio for this. To put this into perspective, the current stock to flow ratio of Bitcoin is 120, which means it would take 120 years to create as many coins as there are currently in circulation for Bitcoin. And from this, this model of PlanB derives a price band which Bitcoin should trade in. And this price band currently is between the lower band here is at 250,000. The upper band is at 1.8 million. The fair price, according to this model, is around $700,000. We can see here in the past that the model actually worked quite well. It broke a little bit down after the halving of 2020. So if Bitcoin is to follow this model still for this cycle until the next halving in 2028, it still should, you know, have a lot of momentum to move to the upside, probably all the way to $700,000. This one you'll find as well on TradingView for free. As I said, there are the links to all the indicators for these models on TradingView in the pinned comment of this video. Last but not least, I want to talk about what probably is the most complex model of those three. It's a model that has gained a lot of traction just recently for the past 1.5 to 2 years, I would say. It's the so-called Bitcoin power law model by Italian physicist Giovanni Santostasi, I think his name is pronounced. Give him a follow on X. And this model basically says Bitcoin is a power law. What is a power law? A power law always describes how two variables interact with each other. If X is, for example, 1 and Y is 3, then the relationship between those would stay the same. So if X is 3, Y would be 9, always 3 times of what X is. And Giovanni, in a nutshell, applied this to Bitcoin and said, well, Bitcoin grows according to a power law. And for me, this is very fascinating because this model not only describes very well what the current price and what the current fair price of Bitcoin is, this model also describes very well the ups and downs, the cyclical patterns of Bitcoin that you see: 3 years of bull run, 1 year of bear market. Now, without going into too much detail about the math behind this, so what is really cool, in my opinion, about this model is its application to decide is Bitcoin over or undervalued currently is pretty simple, because you can get a power law price. So according to this power law model, the price of Bitcoin, the fair price, the calculated price, is currently at $99,214. The fair value, which is the median between the red and the green band, is at $119,000. And it's quite surprising, especially if we look really for the past almost year, how well Bitcoin like to stick to this fair value of Bitcoin. So where we are trading right now actually is the fair price of Bitcoin. Now, what is interesting is here the band position. So in these upper and in this whole structure marked by the green lower band and the red upper band, Bitcoin is at 49.9%, so almost 50. In the past, a good go-to strategy always was to start accumulating Bitcoin if the band position is in around 20% or 30%, and to start selling Bitcoin once it goes over 70%. There's another version of this created by Giovanni also, which shows many, many more details than my coding skills can do here in PineScript for TradingView. So if you're interested in this, you might want to check that out. Giovanni is expecting Bitcoin, according to the power law model, to top out in this bull market probably mid of January 2025, around $200,000. So this is something that it has really very good in common with the logarithmic regression model, which also says somewhere between $200,000 and $250,000, somewhere in October, November, probably the top is going to be, with the exception that the power law model says this is going to be in January of 2025. Now, these are of course all models, but these are all models that worked so far pretty well, not necessarily always in being absolutely pinpoint right where the top and the bottoms are, but to help you with the timing. So next time you, for example, look at this indicator and you see the band positions at 70% or 80%, yeah, maybe that should be a time for you to sell Bitcoin. If you see it at 20 or 30%, maybe that's a good time to buy Bitcoin. This brings me to the end of this video. I hope you liked this video. If you did, leave me a like, leave me a comment, subscribe to the channel. And I hope it helps you for the future to cut through the noise, to determine for yourself is this right now a good time to buy Bitcoin, or should I maybe think about selling Bitcoin? Take care and bye-bye.